And the same is true of the advocacy groups. So forget about all the fights that we've had and all the stereotypes that we've had. We all want quality. Now, why is that important? It's important because of the second point. We can use the survey process to improve quality. If you accept that we all want quality, we should be able to sit around a table, and Andy can talk about whether it's happened or not, and decide what are the things that really matter in a nursing home. And you know what? We already know. We need to have a robust care plan for our residents. We need to execute that plan. We need to provide a safe, comfortable environment for our residents. We need to keep them active. We need to have resident and employee satisfaction programs that keep things vibrant. If we use QIS or whatever survey process that we end up with to measure those things, not only will we be measuring the right things, but nursing homes across the country will focus on those things. The problem is that the survey process has too often been used to measure things that don't matter. Now, I'm not saying they never matter, but facilities have for years gotten deficiencies written up for things that maybe in 100,000-to-1 chance something might happen to a resident that causes a deficiency. And what that does is it leads the industry to worry about things that might happen in a 100,000-to-1 chance. What we know is that every day residents need good care plans. Every day they need to live in a safe environment. Every day they need to be kept active. And if we have a survey process that focuses on those things that they need every day and that can measure what we should be doing, we will end up with a process that doesn't just tell us how we're doing, we will end up with a survey process that improves quality itself. The third thing that we need to do is we need to reward results. And that can only happen if we break down the mistrust that's out there. One of the ways that we reward results is that we allocate our time, our survey time, in a more efficient way. AHCA has introduced legislation be introduced to Congress that was an idea, I believe, of Mary Ousley, who's speaking later today. And the idea is that if you have a facility that is consistently getting good surveys, CMS and the regulators should spend their time not focused on that facility, they should spend their time focused on the facilities that are struggling. It makes total sense. It's what we would do in a business. In our businesses, if our dietary departments are doing extremely well, but we're struggling in maintenance, we don't spend all of our time on dietary or an equal number of time. We focus on maintenance. We make it better. And yet we haven't been able to come to that simple and logical conclusion because of mistrust that exists within the system. The other way that we reward results is that we need to have a survey document that is more positive. You know, the surveys right now just focus on what you've done wrong. And put yourself in the shoes of a 55 or 60-year-old woman searching for a place for her parents, and you read the surveys as they're written right now, and they're scary. Even in very good facilities, they're scary. We need to have more of a collaborative document, listing the things that happen every day that the facility is doing well, and then talking about the areas where it's being challenged. And finally, in a truly collaborative environment, we would never have a system that says that no matter how well everybody is doing, 20% are automatically going to be rated as one star. That is a symptom. It's a symptom of the fact that we've got barriers that we need to break down. But I'm optimistic that we can, because I genuinely believe that all three interest groups, all three advocacy groups, want quality. And once we can agree on that, and once we can come up with reasonable quality measures, we will turn this thing around. Now, I think about the incredible opportunity that we have in our profession, the reason that Stacy and I feel so strongly about it. And she'll be out at the AHCA conference, and I hope you'll get a chance to meet her. We are currently taking care of the greatest generation. Many of the people that are in our buildings right now were born in the Depression. They or their spouses fought in World War II, and all of them were a part in making this country what it is today. They did that by bringing the country together at critical times. And now it's our turn. It's our turn to bring together all of the groups, regulators, advocacy groups, providers, profits and nonprofits, large companies and small companies, if we all come together, we can create a survey system and a quality that will make the future proud. Just as the greatest generation came together to give us the country that we have, now is the time for us to come together so that we can take care of the greatest generation. Thank you all very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
At this time, does anyone have any questions that they'd like to pose to the governor? Don't get shy on me.
You can ask me about sports, politics. If anybody has any questions, I'd be glad to try to answer them. And if you can't think of anything right now, I'll be at the AHCA conference in Long Beach and plan on getting around as much as I can at that conference.
You're not going to be there.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Matt, could you stand? This is Matt Luger from Alliance Purchasing Network. You have to talk really loud because we're holding, waiting for, here comes a microphone. Hold that thought. Just think all of you get this opportunity. Here you go.
Governor, what are your thoughts on the potential for linking quality with public reimbursement practice?
This is going to sound like a political answer. I don't know enough about it yet. The idea is, I can understand the intrigue of the idea, but the threshold that we would need in order to do that would be a almost universally agreed, accepted definition of quality. You all know from floating around the Medicare website right now that you see facilities that are one star and you're like, I can't believe that's a one star, and you see some that are five and you can't believe that either. So until, you know, my initial thought is that until we get to what we believe is a very confident way of measuring how we're doing, I'd be reluctant to go in that direction. An idea that I've had, and I hate to even throw it out before I fully vet it, but an idea that I've had is maybe linking reimbursement to effort. If we can develop quality improvement programs that we can believe in, and then go to the folks that determine reimbursement and say, we'll get 80% of our people in this program, but the reimbursement has to be at an acceptable level for us to afford it, I can see that. So I'm more comfortable with the notion of reimbursement for effort than I am for actual results, just because I don't trust the way the results are currently being measured.